So let's go to Senator Gillibrand.
Thank you all for being here. I'm very grateful for your testimony and your participation. I have three questions, and I'll ask them all, and then you can, whoever wants to answer them can answer them. The first is emergency planning and an evacuation zone. We have Indian Point, as you know, where 17 million people live within 50 miles of a nuclear power plant. Now, familiar with the geography of New York, you know that in the event of an evacuation of New York City, the only options are north or west, which means you would have a large number of people evacuating towards Indian Point. Since Fukushima, the FERC recommended that Americans within 50-mile radius be evacuated. So that sends a very mixed message for preparedness. So my question is, has the NRC taken any steps to work with FEMA and other government agencies to develop an emergency plan that encompasses the shadow evacuation zone? So that's my And then the third and final question is about seismic activity and seismic concerns, because if you are aware, New York actually is on a fault line. So in November, NRC announced that it's requiring Indian Point to conduct a high-level earthquake risk report for both Units 2 and 3, a requirement for plants in the highest seismic risk category. This report must be completed by June 2017. Do you think that more than 2.5 years is an appropriate timeline to complete this study for the plant with recent documented aging infrastructure and its proximity to 17 million people and the high risk? And once the risk evaluation is complete, when would you suggest any actions to address be implemented? So three questions, and whoever thinks their most expertise on this, I'd appreciate a response.
Let me try to run through a couple of those. Let me take your last question first, your seismic activity question. I think 2.5 years is probably reasonable. There aren't a lot of seismic experts in the country. These seismic performance assessments take a long time to do, and we want to make sure that they're done properly and thoroughly. In the interim, we have required plants that have qualified to do this extra analysis, this extra evaluation, to ensure that they have safety systems in place, and we are going to be inspecting them for that. Okay? And they've given us their plans on that. They will by the end of this year, and we will be inspecting them for that. Okay? And let me also say that with regards to Indian Point, we put them in our first priority category to move out on this, and they asked to be taken out of that first priority category. We refused. Yes. In terms of emergency planning, emergency preparedness, we do closely coordinate with FEMA on this. Mm-hmm. We do have extensive regulations. We are actually in the process of strengthening our regulations on emergency preparedness based on what happened in Fukushima. And we do conduct regular drills and exercises with the state and local officials.
Do you have a written plan that I can see? Because I just know the experience from Superstorm Sandy. If we had had to evacuate, we wouldn't have been able to, because most of the roads in that region were closed because of downed power lines, because of downed trees. And so we had days when people could not actually use the roads to get their families to school, to work throughout Westchester County. So,
no, I completely understand and empathize with your concerns on this issue. I think you're right on track to be concerned about this. We ourselves are looking at this, and we will get you that information.
So I definitely want to see updated reports, because also the confluence of factors during Superstorm Sandy were very concerning. You know, we had swells up to, I think it was 10 feet. Mm-hmm. I think our clearance was 12 feet. It was something very close.
Right.
And it was very close. And so a storm with just a little more strength, a little more flooding, a little more rain would have perhaps overwhelmed the plant.
Right. And we're looking at that too.
And we only had a second generator, only one backup. So again, if you just look at Fukushima as an example of all the things that can go wrong that you can't possibly imagine could go wrong, I was beginning to see it during Superstorm Sandy. If it was 2 more feet,
right,
if it flooded the second generator, you can see it happening, and then I saw all the trees down and the power lines down. There would be no evacuation availability.
You're right to be concerned about these issues, and we are too. And we are taking our lessons from Fukushima and from Superstorm Sandy and ensuring that there are flood hazard analyses being redone for Indian Point, for other plants as well.
Okay.
So be assured that we're on top of this. When in terms of cybersecurity, yes, this is